know how long it has actually been since I spent the whole night clubbing?
It's longer for me, I'm sure about that.
Wait, I'm sorry, longer?
Yeah.
Longer or never?
I had a great time, I really did.
Me too.
And I'm glad that you convinced me to duck out of that boring Upper East Side dinner party and go to the Soho Club instead. That was fun.
Well, you know, you gotta keep me around because I know all of the good places.
Really, like the Lincoln Avenue subway line?
What was wrong with that?
Oh,
nobody got mugged? No, your driver picked us up. Here you go. Your driver picked us up. He dropped us off, you know, at the airport. Everybody was fine. Anyway, you liked it.
I know. It was the perfect cap to the holiday season. But I have to admit, I was dreading it this year. But I enjoyed myself because of you.
Are you hungry? I made the three cheese cure, so.
I'm afraid to ask.
No, it's really good. It's actually macaroni ricotta. It's got jack and cheddar, and it's been in the fridge the whole night. It's perfect.
Mm.
Perfect right now, and it is the thing to eat after a night like last night. And actually, just so you know, Alfred insisted that he help me make it. He was so cute.
Of course he did. He thinks that you are a most charming lady.
Lady? Wow, well, I must be faking it good enough for Alfred, so.
No. You are a lady. Or it counts. What?
No, nothing.
What?
Nothing. I just, I was thinking about you dancing last night.
Really? Well, you know, I got a few moves in my, repertoire.
A few moves, yeah? Like a few kind of like, chicken moves?
Excuse me?
Yeah, I'm sorry. It was so cute. You're like dancing to the beat and you're doing this like, it was a kind of like a flapping thing. Yeah. Yes, you did. It was totally drunk chicken. Drunk chicken.
Okay, fine.
I'm sorry. This is pitiful, but I promise, I will take you dancing, but I will teach you moves so you can rock the dance floor next time.
Okay. I'll take you up on that.
Good. Three cheese cure coming right up.
You know what? You go ahead. I'm so exhausted.
Oh, okay. You want to take a nap first?
Hmm? Yeah. Yeah, that sounds good. I'm gonna take a nap first.
I'm not interrupting.
Hey, no. Okay.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry. I think I sat down and must have dozed off.
No. It's okay. No apologies necessary.
I'm so sorry. We were just exhausted. So. It's fine. Late night?
We were in Manhattan for a business function.
Yeah, and then I dragged him to a dance club, kicking and screaming.
I wouldn't exactly say that.
Yeah, me either, once we got you on the dance floor.
Don't listen to her.
What? No, of course, what? He was great. He was brilliant. We found out he loves to dance, who knew? But anyway, we had a great time, and we got home this morning, and that's why we're so tired. But, well, it sounds like you guys had fun.
Yeah. So, hey, Aiden,
Say hi, Daddy.
So, I'm sorry, did we schedule some daddy time, and I somehow tuned it out or something?
No, I just had a little time off of work, so I wanted to surprise you. But if you're tired, I can come back.
No, not at all. I'm glad you guys came by. And this guy's got more hair. How did that happen in 2 days?
I change fast.
Yeah. Okay, so listen, I'll go and get changed, and I'll be right back there.
Okay.
I'm so sorry. I left my cell phone.
Brooklyn. Aiden and Nicholas and I are going to have a family day, so you don't really need to be here.
Oh, yeah. No problem. I would never want to interfere in Nicholas's time with Aiden.
Okay. All right. Good. Just so we understand each other.
Yeah. You know, just so we understand each other. If we're going to play this game, I'm going to make it known that I did not, you know, overlook the fact that here you are banging on his door ready to manipulate Nicholas again.
I'm really sorry if you have a problem with it. I would send Aiden over by himself, but He isn't walking yet.
Oh, it's so funny. You know, Liz, I actually need to hand it to you because you're tougher than you look.
Nicholas is Aiden's father. We don't want our child growing up rootless or unwelcome.
Of course not. I wouldn't either. But I actually get what's going on here. See, you woke up and you realized you're not getting Lucky back. And so that leaves you, a single mother of three, struggling. And then, you know, boom, off goes the light bulb. Nicholas is rich. And Nicholas can take great care of you guys. So here you are trying to parlay this mommy gig into getting him back. It's not gonna work.
I think you're a little bit jealous.
Okay, I'm back. So, what shall we do? Wanna go for a walk? I know you love the horses. You wanna go down the stables?
What do you wanna do? Are you sure it's okay for us to stay?
Yes.
Brooklyn thought you might be a little tired.
No, not at all. I always have time for you and Aiden.
See? I told you, Liz. I told you, even though he's really tired, he would always, always have time for you and Aiden.
You wanna hold him?
Yeah, of course.
Actually, you know, Aiden's had a little cold and I would really hate for you to get sick.
Oh yeah, no, thank you very much. I actually have a lot of errands to run, so I'm just gonna go, bye.
I'll call you later, okay?
Okay, sounds great.
See you soon, bye.
Oh, thanks for bringing him by.
Oh, sure. Aiden really misses his dad. And so do I.